Hello and welcome to yet another Commander Lucosa video for Elite Dangerous, which I believe is now the 25th of these. Some might think that I'm now running out of things to speak about, and you may have a point, but there is at least something new for me to mention in this video. We start, as always, at my status page, where part of that change is rather obvious. Kills have gone up slightly, and very slightly, only by 1 to 36, but the balance has gone down quite a bit compared to how it was last time, despite the fact that I've been continuing to do trades and everything else. So we are now at 2.8 million. So where has that missing million gone, I hear you ask? Well, it wasn't because I had to buy a new ship. Well, actually, technically, that's not true. I did have to buy a new ship, but it wasn't because the previous one was destroyed. It was because I wanted to do something really stupid, which was change my weapons loadout. But oh no, this wasn't having it. It wouldn't let me sell any of my weapons. Well, it would come up, do you wish to sell the value zero? And even if I thought, okay, sod it, I'll get rid of it for zero, it then said there was an error and it couldn't connect to the server and it wouldn't let me do it. This is a bug that seemed to appear 5 days ago. Now, in that time, there has been no word on the cause or, you know, what is being done to fix it from the devs whatsoever. In fact, they haven't even acknowledged that it exists. I am one of a growing number of people who have ticketed it. As far as I'm aware, none of us have had a reply. Now, I'm sure they are doing something to fix it, but it would be nice for them to at least let us know. So anyway, the only workaround at the moment is to sell your current ship and buy a new one. Doing that has resulted in me losing, in fact at the time I lost around 1.7 million to buy another Anaconda and to refit it with the new weapons loadout that I wanted to try. Thankfully, although I've only been able to test it once, as you can see from the fact that the kill count has only gone up once, the new weapons load seems to be working okay, so it's not been a complete disaster. We'll skip modules. You may notice in function, turret weapon mode, which is the one that was always changed, is now showing forward fire. The reason being, I no longer have any. Get onto that in just a sec. Just to show you, cargo is currently 228 tons of mineral extractors. It's one of the few items I can take to my intended destination where I will make a profit on it. So that's why I have those. They're not exactly the sort of cargo that you're going to make a resounding fortune on, but well, it's worth taking anyway. Now here is the new weapon loadout. First thing you may notice is I now have no less than 4 gimbal pulse lasers, all of which are class 5. The 4th pulse laser has replaced the plasma accelerator. The other weapons to be replaced are the previously mentioned 2 class 2 turreted multi-cannons. They have been replaced by 2 class 4 rail guns, which means I have to aim with them, unlike the turrets, but they will do significantly more damage per shot than those turrets ever were. So so I decided to give them a go. I've still got the two missile racks, and rather like before, I still haven't used them. So I don't know what I'll do with that. They're there anyway. Kill warrant scanner, cargo scanner, still there. So is the chaff launcher, the heatsink launcher, and although you can't see it on here, the point defense turret is fitted. The only thing that I don't have on this ship that I did have on my original is the docking computer, which I'm simply just not going to bother with. Right, now you'll see here that we are currently in a Tillian system in the Maunders Hope docking station. My destination is Keres, which I'm probably saying wrong. Now, why have I chosen there? Well, Keres is an anarchy state, and I figured where better to get some practice on finding out how these weapons are working than to go to an anarchy state. Well, okay, the war zones and the extraction zones are probably better, but this will do. And it does of course mean that I'll probably have to check out some of the unidentified signal sources, because I can't rely on just being, you know, just getting interdictions. But it would be nice to get some interdictions just to see if this new weapons load can finally give me the chance of destroying them before they take one look at me and then bugger off again. I'm not all that hopeful that they will. I think they'll still be able to run, but we can give it a go. So with that in mind, let's give it that go. Here we go.
Ship released. Engines engaged. Drive charging.
later systems that have been more challenging than this, and this is supposed to be an Anarchy system.
Request granted.
Find another I heard people say Hermitage was an anarchy state. I keep looking down, of course there's absolutely nothing there. The racket pool's not anarchy, is it? No. The parlour definitely isn't. More gore is, but surely that's out of range. Yeah, I think that is. BD plus 47, 21, 12. All of these systems. I think I've been to Ross 1015 actually, because it's one of those that I was sure was out of range. So, I'll tell you what we'll do then. I don't trust I'm going from one extraction to another. But I've not been to this system before, so bollocks to it. Let's go there. Just so I can say I've been there.
Ship released. Engines engaged. Drive charging. Thank you.
two Anarchy systems I have been to, not only zero interdictions, but zero unidentified signal sources for me to even go and look at. Have they taken them all out of the fucking game or something?
Request granted. Docking successful. Engines disengaged.
I didn't even bring anything here, did I? So, this trip cost me 784 credits. Guess it could be worse. Extraction, but it doesn't send out metals. It sends minerals to Bog, Howling, or LHS-287. See, now it doesn't send them to Bog at all. It goes right past it. It sends it to somewhere that's way out of range.
Warning, cargo hold at maximum capacity.
Engines engaged.
Thank you. drive charging.
Four, three, two, one.
Request granted. Successful. Engines disengaged.
auto, and give it one last bash.
Cargo hold at maximum capacity.
So I still have 3 million in the balance after filling all the cargo. It's not bad. Just double check that I did set course. Yes, I did. Let's go, last trip.
Drive charging. Thank you.
around here, that's because I had absolutely nothing in there.
Drive charging. Target shields offline.
Yes.
drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1. Target shields offline. Target destroyed. Drive charging.
This is almost certainly going to be the last burst of the
4, 3, 2, 1. Target shields offline. Target destroyed. Request granted. Successful. Engines disengaged.
So that was video number 25, and wasn't it just fan-dabby-dozy? Well, that's it, alright. This is Commander Vicova signing off.